Good evening. Tonight we're going to take this SJ4000 clone and change this lens. It's relatively simple to do. First things first, remove the front. Remove the front shield. Pops right off, see? No big deal. Now there's a ring around the lens. Remove that. It pops right off with a knife. Put that to the side. Now, I've already changed the lens on this to turn it into a full spectrum camera. You see the little red dot? I put that to match up with the dot on the collar so I can get close for focus and then do the fine tuning. So anyway, I'm not even going to bother to take the battery out, because unlike most videos, they show you to take the whole face off here and so on and so forth. There's no need to do that. Just unscrew the lens. And as you can see, there's the lens. And there's the camera body. Here's the original lens that I have from it. Here's the lens that I hope to put on it. This is the Fujian 35mm F1.7 C Mount Lens. How do I propose to do that? Well, by getting this adapter. On one side is CS mount. The other side is the same threads as the GoPro and the SJ4000 and their clones. So, I'm simply going to screw this in. The only thing I'm not sure about is, will it let me focus all the way to infinity? I have a feeling the answer is no, because let's take that back out again. My goodness. Okay, if you look, the threads on this are much, much longer, so this lens goes much deeper into the camera. This doesn't go as deep, so the focal length, or the focal distance from the sensor to the lens, isn't going to be the right dimension, more than likely. But I'm just doing this to take a chance. If that happens, I can take off this shield and possibly cut down the mount until I get it to the right focal length, which I believe is 0.68 of an inch. So anyway, let's stick this back in there. And now, of course, I'm having a problem to get it in properly. Seem to have cross-threaded it. That's not good. Okay. Now we take this. is a C mount lens, which is the, again, the Fujian 35mm f1.7, and we simply screw that in. That gives us a little more grip to turn it in some more. Hopefully that'll let us do it. So as you can see, wasn't very difficult. I'm going to split away now, and then I'm going to shoot with the SJ4000 to see if we can get it to focus. Even if I can't get it to focus to infinity, that's not the end of the world. As long as I can get it to focus at all in most of the apertures, I'll be happy. All right, hang on, we'll be back in a moment. And we're back. It seems I had to remove this plate as well to get the adapter to fit properly. And so the camera looks like this now. This is the SJ4000 with a Fujian 35mm f1.7 lens on it. Yes, it's rather large. Yes, the innards of the camera are not very well protected at this moment. I assume that if I open this hole up a little bit to allow the adapter to pass, I can probably get away with putting this back on. But for the moment, I'm just trying it like this. So, in my initial test, it seems to be focusing okay. To infinity even. So let's go shoot some footage. So I'll show a little quick bit of footage in a moment. Hang on a bit, I'll be right back. And we're back. Now we're shooting with the SJ4000. I removed the secondary plate from the camera, as I showed you. And now I'm able to seat the adapter deeper into the camera. And now I can get infinity focus on my C-mount lens, at least on this Fujian 35mm f1.7 I am. The 35mm Fujian is one of my favorite C-mount lenses. It's nice and sharp, gives a nice look. It doesn't compare to a modern lens, although it is a modern lens, but it's an inexpensive, made in Asia, $25-ish C-mount lens. I have a bunch of C-mount lenses. This is just one of them. The small sensor on this camera is giving about a 5.2 times crop, making this 35mm about 182mm focal field of view equivalent. So hopefully you're seeing more than just my nose or my lips or one eye or something. I'm shooting this with the built-in microphone on the SJ4000. Hopefully it doesn't sound too atrocious. Again, I used this $35 clone direct from China simply because I didn't mind destroying it. I figured $35, if I destroyed it, I'm not out much. The adapter was another $12. The lens I already had. I used to use it quite extensively on my Blackmagic Pocket Cinema camera, as well as on my Panasonics. And I've actually used this on my Sonys in crop mode, and it actually works pretty good on those as well. But anyway, I'm sure this is plenty of footage to get an idea of if this looks decent.